with the updated policy or the suggested response in the consultation. I was struck by paragraph 6.2 and 6.3 in the report, and certainly welcome the way it's being done to try and think ways that we can use other legislation, opposed to the old antisocial behaviour legislation, to ensure that where appropriate we can use that surveillance where necessary. I did have a look at the Protection from Harassment Act one night when I couldn't sleep. I did note that, and like a language can sometimes be important in these things. In paragraph 6.2, you've written that you might be able to get government surveillance agreed for harassment that forms a campaign of harassment. Yeah. I've looked at the Act, actually, it only talks about two occasions. I think there's a difference between two occasions of harassment or distress and a campaign. It strikes me that the Protection from Harassment Act actually is, makes it slightly easier for us to have looked at this. The other thing I looked at, which was signposted from another website, was the Public Order Act of 1986, which also carries the offence of harassment. And if it's if there's intent involved, and no intent is necessary in the Protection from Harassment Act, simply that a reasonable person would conclude that it was harassment. But the Public Order Act, if intent is there, also carries 6 months. Doesn't require if you make a campaign or two occasions. So that might be worth looking at. Certainly if someone's banging on walls, I think we can say there's intent involved and maybe rely on the Public Order Act. I think that's what I wanted to say, that whilst we're looking at these things, looking for legislation that carries 6 months, it might be appropriate to look at other pieces of legislation that also carries 6 months. And rather than, we were discussing flighting at the Bexhill constituency, and somebody said, oh, we don't prosecute, we don't get prosecutions on them. And Fagfield said, well, let me tell you, do in Westminster, you can go for a big time. Right? And sometimes you think maybe we're a bit too cautious in applying law and going for it. I made the comments in 6.3 that we're looking at it, thinking about it, etc. I would say, let's go for it. You know, at the end of the day, sometimes it's just up to the guy who wears tights and a wig for a living as to whether you're doing the right thing or not. It depends who you get in front of you. I think, these are important pieces of legislation. Parliament had them in mind for tackling serious antisocial behaviour, and if COVID surveillance and the operation of WIPA will help in these circumstances, I think it should be a difference.
Just to say that harassment can be silent.
Say what?
Well, 6.2 makes a lot of play about noisy harassment, and harassment can be silent.
It can be very useful.
Any other questions? Agreed recommendations? Yeah. Item 12.
Yes, this report submitted to the committee for its approval proposed code of practice on CCTV, which is openly operated with full knowledge of the public. It's meant to be a pretty easily digestible form of the Home Office Surveillance Code of Practice, to which every local authority must have due regard in carrying out its functions. The central themes of the code are there must be a designated person responsible for the proper operation of each system. There should be annual reviews of existing installations, which should include consultation with those persons whose privacy is likely to be affected, and privacy impact assessments to raise up the benefits of each installation against any infringements of privacy, and there must be adequate notices displayed informing the public of the use of CCTV. So it is proposed to paragraph 13, the committee approve and adopt the code of practice and instruct management to put systems in place to ensure compliance with the code and to ensure that annual reviews of all existing CCTV systems are undertaken with priority being given to reviews of systems and buildings and places to complete public access to be completed by their ways of funding and approval.
Do we have any questions? Do we agree those three recommendations?
Agree.
Thank you, Conor. Right, I've not been notified of any urgent information. Business? It's just thanks for your attendance. And see you next week.